Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can analyze days from 2 months on a single line graph. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date all the videos from both Adam and myself. All right, we had a question on the live stream. They were like, hey, Guy in the Cube, I got a year, 2 months, and some days, and I wanna stack them so I could see, you know, is there any pattern or correlation between days from two different months? And I was like, yeah, you could do that. That's pretty easy. Let me show you. I kind of did a demo live, but I didn't explain exactly what I did. And so we decided to do a video, okay? So enough of all this talking. You guys know how I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing I want to show you is the problem, right? And why this could potentially present a challenge. So I created this report, and you can see there's the year. The year is very important. It's a single select year. And then I have the month where you can select multiple months. When they initially said this, I was like, ah, this is easy. You want to graph. So I want to grab my gross profit. I want to graph my gross profit. So I'll drag that to values. So you can see that right there. And then on my axis, man, I got a date. I'm going to drop my date. I got a date. No, I don't. All right, I'm gonna drop that right there and then bring both of my months in my ledger. So now there's 2 months, but the problem is these months, they run continuous because the date on my axis, right, is continuous, and they would never overlay because these days are never in the, they're in a different, you know, part of the sequence. And so you can see how it just keeps going for each month. But what they want to do is they want to take February and put it on top of January. So you can see the split right here, how it just continues. And so instead of it splitting, they just want to take all these days and put them over here. So that's the problem. How do you solve that problem? Well, it's actually pretty easy. And I showed it in the live stream, but I didn't really explain it. So that's what I'm gonna show in this video. So instead of using the day, we're gonna get rid of date. Just X that out. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over to our calendar table. Really easy. We're gonna make a slight modification. Hang on 1 second. I just made an error. That's okay. Shift enter will give me the new line that I want. I'm gonna call this day of month. And then we're just gonna use the day function. We're gonna add that just like that. Before I move on, you can add this day month anywhere in your data. You can add it back in the source. It's probably the best thing that you could do, or you can do it in Power Query, or you can do it in DAX. I do it in DAX because I like to make things portable. All right, so it's really easy to do it, but it's up to you, wherever you want it. So now that I've added this day of month, all I need to do is I can keep this, you know, exactly how I had set everything set up. Just get rid of the date, and instead of putting the date on the axis, I'll put the day of month. And when I drop it, kind of messy, right? But this is every month, you know, for that year. If I choose January, boom, and then I choose February, right? So now I'm comparing these 3 months, and I can see that, you know, February's outperforming here, January's outperforming there. I can add another month, and it can get messy really quickly. If I choose a different year, you could see, right, the values change. Just like that, I set up a nice line graph where I'm analyzing and comparing sales, you know, as they run, you know, across the days in each month. All right, what do you guys think? Have you encountered this challenge before? Have you solved this challenge? Maybe you solved it in a different way. I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.